Discussion on heparin-induced thrombocytopenia syndrome. Heparin-induced thrombocytopenia was described as two types, HIT 1 and HIT 2. HIT 1 is a self-limiting disease and a non-immune-mediated response to heparin, which occurs within 1 to 4 days of exposure to heparin. It is not associated with thrombosis and is unlikely to worsen with continued use of heparin. HIT 1 is mediated by a direct interaction between heparin and circulating platelets. This interaction causes clumping or sequestration of platelets. Thrombocytopenia is usually mild and transient and often returns to normal within 4 days of withdrawal of heparin. HIT 2 or HITTS, heparin-induced thrombocytopenia and thrombosis syndrome, is a more dangerous form in which IgG antibodies against heparin platelet factor 4 complex are formed. It occurs within 5 to 14 days of exposure to heparin and is associated with thrombotic events. The IgG antibody binds to heparin platelet 4 complex, leading to platelet activation, platelet consumption, and thrombocytopenia. The IgG antibodies are known as HIT antibodies or HIT IgG. The antigen-antibody complexes can cause production of tissue factor by their interaction with monocytes. Antibody-mediated endothelial injury can also occur. These in turn can further activate the coagulation cascade. There is also a suggestion that HIT 1 be renamed as non-immune heparin-associated thrombopenia and HIT 2 as just HIT. Many publications refer to HIT 2 as just HIT. In those who have been previously exposed to heparin, the onset is earlier and can occur within hours. HIT is unlikely to be a cause for thrombocytopenia within 5 days of heparin initiation in those who have not received heparin within the previous 3 months. Direct thrombin inhibitors like bivalirudin is a drug of choice in HIT. Though the chance of developing HIT with low molecular weight heparin is lower than with conventional heparin, low molecular weight heparin cannot be used after the onset of HIT. Routine monitoring of platelet count in those receiving heparin is recommended for early detection of HIT. Higher risk patients who are receiving therapeutic doses of unfractionated heparin need at least alternate day platelet count estimation. When warfarin has to be started for conditions like deep vein thrombosis in those with HIT, it should be delayed till platelet count has fully recovered. Warfarin is started at the expected maintenance dose. Loading dose of warfarin is not given. Parenteral anticoagulation is overlapped for at least 5 days until target INR levels have been maintained for 2 days.